In the Museum of Science, I stumbled across a display of an old book, Proceedings of the Royal Society, from 1693, and the page it was open to was a paper by the astronomer Edmund Halley. The paper had absolutely nothing to do with astronomy. Today, that paper is credited as one of the first applications of actuarial sciences to estimates of population, longevity, and mortality. I'm John Miller, the deliberate engineer. In addition to being a software engineer for 30 years in big tech, I've also spent about 15 of those years working to one degree or another on big data and on data analysis. As a side interest, I've always been interested in how the life expectancy of people has varied over the years. One of my niche interests has been life tables, a type of actuarial table that shows information about births, deaths, and how long you might expect to live given the age you are today. So what is a life table? It's a table based on actual births and deaths for a given year of age, shows how long a typical person is likely to live from that point, and also their chance of dying each successive year. It sounds a little grim, but this is actually super useful for a bunch of different things. Halley's analysis and paper were enabled by a 5-year data set that had been provided by Henri Justel for the city of Breslau in Germany. This provided information about births and the age and sex of people who died every month for a period of 5 years in the late 17th century. With this data, Halley was able to create tables that showed how long somebody was expected to live given their current age and also their chance of dying for each year, a life table. Based on the data, for example, Halley found that the chance of an infant dying in Breslau during those 5 years was about 28%, or having about a 72% chance of making it through their first year of life. He also calculated that the chances of an infant who had survived to their first year making it to 7 years of age was only 69%. When you hear figures like this, it's very important to remember they apply to a particular time and a particular place, in this case, the late 1600s in Breslau, Germany. To make his findings more useful, Halley presented them as a normalized life table. He started out with the first year of life, saying that suppose you had 1,000 people who had reached their first year of life, how many would reach the second year? How many of that remainder would make the third year? And so on. For each of the rows in this table, it would describe the number of people left out of that original 1,000 by that age of life, and also the percent chance of dying before the next year. The paper includes a number of sample calculations. He calculated that the chance of making it to the age of 26 if you were 25 was about 99%. He also calculated that your odds of living to the age of 47 if you reached 40 were about 85%. And finally, he applied this data to insurance rates to help discover the expected value of investing in insurance and help guide the decision about both how much to charge for insurance and whether it was worthwhile for a given payout of insurance and a given premium to invest in that insurance. It lets you make decisions about how to run your life. Suppose somebody comes and they want to borrow $100 for 5 years. Is that a good investment? Are they likely to live those 5 years? Or let's say that you want to sell life insurance or you're considering buying it. This is a great way to calculate whether you're going to get good value out of that or whether you would be better served in terms of expected value by, say, investing in some sort of enterprise that has a known rate of return. Much of the genesis of actuarial sciences traces back to the 1693 paper, but of course things have moved on quite a ways from there and divided and subdivided into all kinds of different disciplines. Those disciplines are out of scope for this short video. However, if you're interested in the current applications of actuarial sciences and in particular life tables, they're very easy to find today. Go to Google and type your region or your country's name and then life table, and you'll probably be brought right to the page. The city of Breslau had changed its name to Wrocław and was now part of Poland. And so I took a look at the Polish life tables, and sure enough, I was able to find data from 2021 for that very same city that was discussed in the paper by Edmund Halley. Some excerpts from the 2021 life table published by Poland as it applies to Breslau. First, I'm happy to report that infant mortality rates dropped from 28% in the first year of life to being less than half of 1%, similar to the rest of the first world. Somebody who made it to a year old in 1693 Breslau only had about a 69% chance of making it to 7 years of age. Today, that statistic is 99.9%. Your chance of making it from age 50 to age 60 in 1693 Breslau was about 70%. Now it's 93%. If you were one of the very rare people who made it to 70 years of age in 1693 Breslau, your chances of seeing your 80th birthday were about 29%. Today, it's about 43%. Since I was American, I was curious about the American stats, so I looked up the American life tables, and I found two interesting things. The first is the life table itself, which is fun to take a look at and see how much longer I'm expected to live. The second thing was a discussion of changes in longevity in life tables between 1900 and the forecasted values for 2100. It's really interesting to see how mortality rates have changed and how much longer people are living today versus 1900 and what they project happening for the next 80 or so years. If you are interested, take a look at that. It does include some math, but if you made it through high school algebra, chances are the math is going to be accessible to you, and there's lots of interesting stuff to read without worrying about the math part. So, circling around to where we started, museums are fantastic places to learn about our past and to find things that may be interesting in terms of understanding really how good we have it today, and even inspiring us to learn about things that we never would have thought about doing otherwise. This entire video comes out of a single stand that I happened to see in the information sciences display at the Science Museum. It is far from the most interesting artifact there. I highly recommend, if you're ever in London, go ahead and take a look at the Science Museum or look up your local Science Museum and find some interesting threads to start plucking at yourself. Thanks a lot for watching. Hi, this is John. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please think about subscribing so you get notified of my future videos. Also, if you are interested, you might want to check out the video I have linked here. Thanks, and keep on pushing forward.